I am at a crossroads right now, and I honestly don't know exactly what to do, what the answer is. Fragmented theater is dead. Dead. Absolutely no point in destroying it even further. I'm in London at this moment to have meetings with different people in the theater here, and I have relatives here. I have an aunt who just became 90, turned 90. What it did was to explore the stage as if it was a fragment of their mind, iconoclast. Sure. It's much more a matter of introducing new stuff, television projections, introducing new media. The stage was the mind of the director. Right. And sometimes you'd have 5 minutes of absolutely nothing but darkness. And that was very new. This was late 60s, early 70s, you know. It was another world. It was completely revolutionary and still not accepted. A company called The Exploding Galaxy. It was a street theater. It was everything. Performance art was called. It encompassed everything. It encompassed painting. It encompassed. There was a Filipino guy called David Medalla. There was an American poet, a concrete poet called something Fitzgerald. I can't remember his first name. And I learned a lot. I mean, I learned everything there was to learn about theater. London is very much into realistic. I mean, you know, London discusses the price of milk and the virginity of their children. Social realism. Edward Bond, Alan Bennett, David Hare, and all these other Davids. There are thousands of Davids. I mean, call yourself David here in the theater, you know? No, I realized then, at the age of 27, I realized that, you know, I'm not a director. Directing is like directing traffic. I'm not going to spend my life motivating other people. I've actually got something very, you know, personal to say. Why am I not saying it? Why am I using other people to say it for me? So I actually sat down and I wrote, started writing my own material. It was so controversial and so polemical that it was good, because people started getting so fucking upset. I used Carmen, you know, Bizet and Mary Mayer's myth. I deconstructed the myth of Carmen, and I deconstructed the entire music composed by Bizet, the entire opera. I made it into a play. I realized that it you have to take it. You have to take the blow to the stomach, because it just simply is like that. What you should really believe in yourself and not really give a damn about any reviews, bad or good. I hold it back a little bit, I move it forward, depending on what we call the breathing. Everything is different every night. The actors are a little slower. The audience from country to country, because we travel all the time, it's a little different that night. I give myself a job of controlling the entire thing via headsets. I do the lights, I do the sound, and I actually do all the stage business via headsets. I do all the cueing. So my role is actually to guide them through this incredible maze. I don't have the answer. I'm not saying that I have the answer. What I'm saying is that we've got to start for a bit. We've got to start to think. I don't think art is worth a dime anymore in the world today.
So you're saying that for your own productions then?
Yeah, yeah.
They're just purely, it's just purely entertainment?
It's entertainment for the bourgeoisie. Entertainment of the bourgeoisie, absolutely. I've been given 6 months to develop a project, and yet I'm completely lost. I mean, this person who is used to doing 6 plays a year hasn't done a single play in a year. There's something to be said about that. I don't want to repeat the formula of fragmenting blackouts. Blackout, actors out, new scene. I know the formula is easy to do. I mean, I know how to do this kind of bullshit. I've done it. You know, we've got to start looking at the turn of the last century. Duchamp, the entrance of Marcel Duchamp and Sigmund Freud and Arnold Schoenberg were so significant. You've got to know history. And this is what I tell every time I do a workshop. This is what I tell my students. If you don't know history and the course of history and how it is perverse, it is perverse. History is amazingly perverse. Then forget it.